Thank you for joining me. Today we're going to look at this Christmas shoebox that I have packed for Operation Shoebox, which is run by the Samaritan's Purse. For those who don't know, Operation Shoebox runs every year, and it's where you pack a shoebox or something similar. You pack it with toys and school supplies and other goodies for children. And then these are shipped off all around the world. So there are three age categories to choose from. The first is 2 to 4. Second is 5 to 9, and the third is 10 to 14. You can do it for a boy or a girl. So as you can see, this box is for a girl aged 10 to 14. You can print these labels off from online. And I've just stuck it down with some sellotape. Instead of a shoebox this year, because I didn't have one, I found this box, which is a similar size to a shoebox, except it's already decorated, and I got this for £3. From Poundland, because that's just the world we're living in. So let's open the box and see the things that I've bought. I'll go through and explain what I've got and why. When she opens the box, this is what she'll see. So let's go through and take a look. Firstly, we have these tissues. I don't want to crinkle them too much, because we want the packet to look fresh. is always handy to have. Next, we have this bouncy ball. It's a little ladybug. She's very cute. And they can play catch with it. And it also bounces quite high. Because sometimes you buy a bouncy ball, it doesn't bounce very high. It's quite underwhelming. But she is. Next, I have these slipper socks. It has this pretty glittery bow. And they are so soft and warm. These are great for the cold nights. It did say on the Samaritan's website that most of the boxes will be going to Moldova, Romania, Poland, and the countries that are taking in Ukrainian refugees, and I was actually fortunate enough to go to Moldova this year and help out with some of the refugee children out there, and also just the Moldovan village children. So it kind of gave me an idea too of what the children like. I remember a group of girls who were in the 10 to 14 age category, and I got to see what kind of things they enjoyed playing with and what accessories they liked to wear. And so when I was packing this box, I had those girls in mind. And so here you can see we have four rainbow earrings, and these are always fun. These are DIY keychains. They get to make them themselves, and there's four in there so they can give some out to siblings and to friends. And you can get these from Walmart. You can see it has the four rainbow keychains and the string or the rope for the beads and the little okay. So it's always good to include something that they can make, especially with the old age. Also, I find it helpful to pack a sewing kit, but I haven't got that for this box yet. Next is deodorant. It's important to get the stick and not the liquid or the gel. I help out at the processing centers, so the places that go through the boxes, and they will get rid of anything containing liquids. So make sure to get the When packing, I know what to pack because I write it all down in different categories. And if you want to see more information on how I do that, I will be linking a blog, my blog post, in the description below. These are just some hygiene wipes. Toothbrush, scrunchie, and a face flannel. I won't fiddle with this too much. Normally I like to get a lid for the toothbrush. I couldn't find one this year. I also like to get a large canvas bag. But again, all I could find this year was a smaller sized one with a rainbow on. But I thought it would go well with the chain. And these are always good just so they can hold things in. Inside this case here, soap, these are just basic essentials, and I normally put a soap box in anyway, but after living in Moldova for 2 weeks in the villages, I realize how important it is to include things like this, because oftentimes they don't have a place to put the soap, because they bathe outside. Okay, I got this from Holmes. Next one is a hairbrush. L-O-V-E. Love. Accessory bag. It's just a nice little place where they can keep their things in. Inside here, they have purple scrunchie and a pink scrunchie. Girls love accessories, so I like to have a little goodie bag of different things they can mooch through. This is a little mirror. Again, I just couldn't find one this year. Some little scissors. These can be nail scissors. And they are actually quite strong. I did test them out to make sure that they were good quality, because they were cheap, and they were. They are good quality, because you need scissors for this. But you can also use them for other things. Which brings us on to some tweezers. Age where they want to start plucking, and then lastly some watermelon shine lip balm. This is just a little pack of goodies that I think she will like. Again, most of these were from Poundland. Let's go through this water bottle. I always like to include a water bottle. In Moldova, when I went, in the village that I went to, people got their water from a well. Another way to get some more water. And water bottles also to pull up as extra storage. So I've got some if I can get it out, some jewelry pieces. I wasn't sure if a ballerina was a bit too childish, but I don't know. I thought it was pretty. And if they don't like it, they can always give it away. And I have a little charm bracelet. Unicorn, star, love, little gem, and a unicorn there. It's stretchy as well, so it should fit round. is from Hamburgens. Next, I put a few headbands in. I took a bunch of these when I went to Moldova in the summer, and the children loved them, so I included some of these. It's very soft material. Especially when it's hot, it's good to keep the hair off the face. Next, I have this game of Jenga, although it's just called show them how to play. But they can always make up their own games. It's always good to include some type of game though. That doesn't include too many words. So last year I think I included Connect Four and Snakes and Ladders. We have a little hat. It's a koala. Inside we have some gloves. I wish I'd got some more of these, because again in the summer the children absolutely loved stickers. And these have strawberries and lipstick, lollipop, love, and donut. Smiley face. Milk. And there's different designs. A panda. Not. Diamond. Rainbow. I included an activity book. This came in a pack of six and I put some in the boys' box, which you can check out on my blog. Although some of the writing's in English, they can just give them something to play around on, and I'm sure a lot of the tasks they can work out themselves. We have a anti-stress coloring book. I think these are more, these pictures are more for an older girl, because a lot of the coloring books have like farm animals and very kiddish designs, but I thought this was more suitable for an older age. So hopefully they'll like this. use for school or a journal. It's a nice little addition. So in here, we have a rubber or an eraser. And pencil sharpener. Pencils with erasers or rubbers on the bottom. The pink and purple and yellow. I like to get these extendable rollers. Just we have some pens. When I do the processing at the centers, a lot of people forget to include pens and pencils, or they will just put in a few markers. That's all they put in the pencil case. But I think it's good to give them a variety of stationery. And finally at the bottom, we have pencil crayons. Pencil crayons is also another thing that a lot of people surprisingly forget to put in. They will include a coloring book, but no crayons. So, if you're doing a box this year, I think crayons is always a good addition. Shoebox. I also have one more thing on the way, which is a torch, a wind-up torch, which is really good because they do have power shortages, so it comes in handy. Last thing is water. Remember, once you've finished your shoebox, you can pay for the shoebox to be sent online and print out a barcode that you can place on the top or underneath, on top of all your things, and then they will send you an email telling you where your box has gone. So last year my box went to Moldova, and it might go there again this year, or somewhere very close. So that is the box. If you're doing the shoebox this year, let me know what you are including and who you're doing a box for. Thank you for spending this time with me. Remember to add a touch of kindness to all that you do today. And I'll see you in my next video.